fire. Building A was set on fire. And the day after, a government officer notified us that the mining company my father had been running for 50 years had to be shut down because we didn't get the legal license.
One day, I received a death threat by email. I found it kind of funny. But then, 2 weeks later, I was fired from the Department of Interior.
Gradually, the head surgeon started leaving me out from the operating room and giving more and more space to younger and less experienced colleagues. At first, I didn't see this as being anyhow related to the fact that I had reported to the hospital board what he was doing. I finally realized they were implanting defective cardiac valves on patients. But as soon as it was clear to me, I knew I had to do something about it.
Some form of embezzlement was going on in my unit, and I told my manager. Someone was stealing from the department, and consequently from the citizens. I couldn't help but do something about it.
The local mining officer made it clear we would have to pay a bribe in order to get our license. We refused and reported him to the authorities. It was then that the government started making us face the most brutal retaliation.
What would you do if you realized that the government you work for defrauds its own people and voters?
What would you say if you knew your boss put your patients' lives at risk?
Wouldn't you take action if your company was threatened by your own government? I'm a whistleblower for my family.
I'm a whistleblower for my patients.
I'm a whistleblower for justice.